Dink, dink.
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 Dong.
Welcome, everyone, back to the Jenna Julien Podcast.
Dink, dong.
I don't feel like singing the intro this
you
time.
You got a dong, dong.
What? No.
Yeah.
Okay, the rules of this podcast
pull
pertain that
pimp,
you can't harass me like that. I don't
Sexual harassment in the workplace.
Whoa.
I'm fired.
Whoa. You could get fired.
Show me that boss.
Where's the boss? Can you fire her?
Oh, my God.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of the Jenna Julien Podcast. This episode is brought to you by Lyft. Right now, guys, ladies, Lyft is looking for drivers. And right now, if you sign up using our URL, which is lyft.com/Jenna Julien, you will get a $500 driver bonus, which will go towards you as a driver. You can make your own hours. You can clock on and clock off as you please. You can get paid fast, and it's driving people around. Really fun. Get started driving with Lyft right now at lyft.com/Jenna Julien. This episode is also brought to you by MeUndies. It's getting to be that time of year again, guys. The Valentine's Day time of year, which is MeUndies Central. Valentine's is very soon, guys. You can give the gift that really matters and the one that they can unwrap again and again.
Oh my God, no.
Which could be matching underwear. Right now, check out their Valentine's collection. Go to MeUndies.com/Jenna Julien and you get 20% off your first order.
No, you did not.
Thank you, MeUndies.
No, you did not.
I didn't do anything. God. What?
Thank you, sponsors.
Thank you, sponsors.
That was next level, though.
Yeah, it was.
Don't just sit there like...
I'm going to just sit here.
Oh, my God.
All right. I will just sit here.
Do you, Julien. Live your life, Julien.
I am living all my life.
Are you going to tell me this dream that you had last night?
No. I told you I was saving it for the podcast.
This is the podcast.
Is that where we are right now? No, I meant like we're going to do a dedicated dream podcast eventually, and we need to compile a bunch of dreams for it, right?
Oh, okay.
Do you want me to tell you on this podcast too?
Well, because I have one
dream. It has to do with Jersey Shore, and it has to do with me being involved in Jersey Shore.
Well, because we're going to get to a little Jersey Shore later in the podcast,
yeah.
Right?
Basically, I was on Jersey
Shore. Why don't you start us off with your Jersey Shore dream? Because we keep watching Jersey Shore.
We rewatched season 1, 2, and now we're on season 3.
4, right?
Season 4. Oh, my
yeah.
God.
It's a great show.
It's a great show.
And I remember everything differently as an adult than I did as a young adult.
Yeah, sort of. I agree with that. But then also, as we watch more seasons, things start to make more sense in
right.
a way. I'm going to save the dream because I want to save it for the Dreamcast.
Ooh, tell us the dream.
No.
Tell
I said I don't want to.
Us the dream. Ew, don't you dare.
You were doing that before we started rolling and it was
so
obnoxious.
You were just on the Jersey Shore, though?
We were leaving. It was the Italy season. I was in Italy, and it had to do with me trying to get back home so we could podcast. I'm not even fucking lying.
Aw, my yacht's stressed. He's trying to get home from Italy when he's not in Italy. Don't try and bite me.
Yeah, and I think part of the reason why it seeped into my dreams the way it did is because we have this TV that, like, it integrates apps, and one of the apps is, like, Hulu, and it doesn't stop playing, ever.
Yeah,
so,
you just keep playing it until forever.
Yeah, it doesn't have that function, like, on Netflix where it's like, are you still watching, you fat ass? It's like, it just plays. So when we fell asleep to it, it would just, continue to play. So it was, like, kind of finding its way into my dreams because
yeah.
I was hearing it while I slept,
I know.
Which is fucking weird if you've ever done that. But, yeah, we've been really enjoying Jersey Shore, and we'll probably... finish off tonight when we're done recording with another episode. And we'll get... Should we just start with the Jersey Shore thing or should we start with the other thing?
Whatever you want.
All right. If
although,
it's whatever,
you know what? Whenever Julien falls asleep, what I like to fall asleep to is Dr. Phil. Because I turn on OWN and I watch Dr. Phil and he puts me to sleep because I have a love-hate relationship with him.
It's like he plays dress-up and calls himself a doctor. Every day is Halloween for Dr. Phil.
You know, he made like $80 million last year.
What a scum. Oh, I fucking hate that.
Some of it's like very exploitative. Is that the word? Exploity. I'm just going to say it's very exploity
sounds
of some
exploity.
Of these people. You know?
Hearing
like it doesn't
him,
always feel like it's coming from a place of caring.
Well, the problem...
A lot of it's just coming from a place of good television.
Well, that and also the problem is like every single thing that someone will say to him on that show, he has... A tried and true answer and fix.
What's that?
No, it's like, I'm saying, like, every time someone has a problem, he's like, oh, well, here's why. And, he's the all-knowing God or something. Like, why do you have an answer for everything?
I don't know.
That's weird.
Because he's Dr. Phil.
If you like Dr. Phil, can you please leave in the comments why I should maybe consider not hating him?
I don't think you're going to find a person that's...
Okay, I hate him.
Maybe. Maybe you will.
All right.
I think a lot of people have a love-hate relationship with Dr. Phil.
We'll circle back. I have just a hate-hate. We'll circle back to the Jersey Shore in the second half of the podcast, because we want to start with a cool new topic that we have about some of the worst jobs on the planet that currently exist. They actually exist.
Dr. Phil.
Number one, being Dr. Phil. Number two, being Dr. Phil's mustache.
Oh my God. Because
that guy doesn't even get paid.
Wow.
He just has to sit there.
No.
He sits atop.
Number three, being Dr. Phil's wife, Robin, who just sits in the audience and smiles the whole show.
She goes to the show.
Every episode. Oof. She just sits there and like grins around. Weird.
Blink once if you don't want to be there, Mrs. Phil.
It's like the first lady of the United Phil. States. Can we just, for one second, like, wait, what?
Do
what
you address her as Mrs. Phil?
No.
Because that's funny.
Dr. Phil. Mrs. Okay, Phil.
What do we want to address?
Like, why do we care that this doctor has a wife that's there in the audience all the time? Does that make him some more, like, credible or, yes, like, reliable?
That's what it's trying to do. Like, it's trying to get you on his side because he's a family man.
But, like, the first lady, why is that a job? Why is the first lady, why do we care what his wife does?
Wow, so, okay, this is a completely different discussion.
I'm serious, though. Why do we care about, if you do your job, we need to also know what your wife does for a living.
It's what we just talked about. It's people trusting a family man or a family woman. It's people trusting someone who is dedicated to...
Why?
I don't know.
Why do people give a fuck?
Well, because that's how our culture has developed in this day and age. Like, we're in 2017, and hundreds of years now, people have gotten married and been families. So
I think that's all stupid. I would love it if a president was like, hey, I'm a gay man, and I'm on Grindr every fucking night,
but you know what?
I will be an incredible president.
No one would trust him.
Hell yeah, dog, live your life.
The problem is, no matter how good he could be at one thing... If you're doing something that people don't find trustworthy, whether or not they have a right to find that trustworthy or not, they're going to. People are always going to view the way
always,
people...
Always, though? You think when millennials grow up that we'll still have the same ideals about marriage or, like, caring about...
Well, look what just happened. Donald Trump got elected. Everyone thought that
millennials.
I know, but I'm just saying. Everyone thinks, like, oh, you know, the millennials are changing the path of everything, and everything's, you know... Everyone's more conscious of what they're saying. Everyone's thinking different now. But then Donald Trump gets elected. So it's like a big kind of like, okay, wait, not yet.
Mm.
So maybe. I mean, I don't know. All I know is that like the vast, vast majority of this country, young and old, I think, trusts, you know.
Yeah, no, I know you're not wrong. I'm just arguing against it.
I know. And that's my argument.
I think we should fucking think about why the fuck do you care?
Well, it's a good point. I don't give a fuck. It seems like an old system.
What Melania Trump does from the moment she wakes up to the moment she goes to bed. I don't give a fuck what she does.
Well, I don't care what she does because she's Melania Trump. I understand the First Lady to an extent. Like, I get that. I understand that there are even some duties that they have specifically as a First Lady, right? But
well, like, if Hillary Clinton was elected, does anyone really give a fuck what Bill Clinton's doing?
Hell yeah.
I don't.
He's fucking around.
I don't care what he's doing.
He's being hilarious.
He was president.
Yeah, I know.
And he was fucking around. I do not care what he does.
He's just gonna be sitting off to the side making faces.
First dad. Are you kidding?
Yeah.
First dad. No. Whatever.
No. I you're onto something there.
But,
you are.
Yeah. Number three worst job is Dr. Phil's wife, Robin, because I don't give a fuck what she does, and I don't give a fuck that she's there.
Yeah, I don't.
If anything, it makes me feel like they have one of those relationships where you just shove all your problems to the bottom and then go to work.
Like, what? Why do I think that after he's done filming these episodes where he's like this healer of all these problems, he goes home and just like has huge strife with everyone, his wife and everyone.
They just don't talk to each other.
Yeah. I think he's, what do you think his deal is like deep down? Like what is he fucked up?
I think he might just like to eat corn and play golf or something. I think that's him. Maybe that's all there is.
He does some fucked up shit. Let's slander him. No, I'm just kidding.
No, Dr. Phil years ago crossed the line with me. They came to my townhouse. They wanted me on the show for something stupid. And I was like, I'm not interested. No, thank you. So they came to my house and left an envelope in my mailbox that was like,
your house.
Please reconsider and come on the show. Give me a call. I'm the producer, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, fuck You, Dr. Phil, you cannot come to my house and leave a note for me. This is not appropriate.
It sounds like borderline extortion.
How is it extortion?
Because they're like, hey, reconsider. We know where you live. Yeah.
It was really inappropriate.
Because there was no postage on it.
No, there wasn't. Oh, someone creepy. Dropped it off. It was creepy. Really, really inappropriate. Like, especially when you have, like, a manager or, like, a business email or ways for people to get in contact with you.
Yeah.
I was working with an agency at the time. Like, there's plenty of ways to get a hold of me that are appropriate, and they did that. I said no, and then they just wanted to try their hand going around.
Wow.
Anyways, I got a bone to pick. I still watch him. He still makes me a little
angry. We hate
watching
Dr. Phil. Don't take it. Don't act like you're.
Well,
you're
that's
tight,
the thing, though, is that it's fucking... not. No, I'm not watching it for Dr. Phil. Some of the subject matter is pretty interesting, and I like watching the people talk about their problems.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
No, I get that.
I like that.
Yeah, I get that.
And also, there's a commercial break every 3 fucking seconds, and I can't handle it.
At least it's not.
Welcome back. At least it's not. So we're here with Angela.
At least it's not the
Sarah, and they're talking about how Angela lit their cat on fire.
But at least it's not the Lifetime app commercials where they blast the volume. Have you guys ever done that? If you watch shows via like the Lifetime or Hulu app, and they play those preset commercials, but the commercials are like high volume.
Yeah,
they like blast. Because they want you to wake up and watch the ad?
We watch Project Runway on the Lifetime app, and there's like the same 3 commercials. It's like, dun, 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 dun,
dun, dun, dun, but it's like 15, 20 points higher in volume.
Julian will fall asleep, and then the commercials will violently wake him
up. Wake me up. Inside.
Whatever. All right. Aside from Dr. Phil's wife having to go to the Dr. Phil show every single episode and sit in the audience.
That's the worst job ever.
And
the second worst job. The worst. That's I prefer the job next to that. That's the worst job. The job I prefer less or more, sorry, is the janitor at a sperm bank.
No.
Yeah, that's number one on the list. I prefer doing that than to be Dr. Phil's wife.
Okay, what does a janitor at a sperm bank do?
Sperm bank floors can be messy and sticky. At the same time, someone has to clean it. So it is the duty of the janitor to make sure that the place is sanitized and the floor is dry and clean. Although donors are given cups to fill with their sperm, oftentimes they manage to miss the cup and not clean it up. So there are, I mean, obviously there's janitors. There's janitors everywhere.
Oh, that's vom. That's
but imagine that
bomb.
You're like scraping because it's all crusty and dried.
Well, you don't know that.
But imagine
if somebody came in there every day to clean it.
Imagine it crusty. I want you to imagine
it. Stop. No.
Don't do that.
Don't
it's
do
crusty.
What?
It's crusty. Say it with me.
Stop.
Say it.
No.
Crusty. Okay, so
that's nasty.
That's actually a job. These are all jobs that are actually
that's not like the
jobs.
Worst thing in the world. I feel like I've heard of worse jobs than that. That's pretty gross, but I can't say that it's the worst.
I feel like if you're a janitor, you're already probably cleaning up like 10%
right gross
sex
stuff.
Yeah, so
well, depending on where you're a janitor. If you're a janitor in a school, you're cleaning up like puke and gross teenage bathrooms and nasty stuff.
I think if you do a different line of work and then you immediately go to janitor at a sperm bank, that might be jarring. But if you're a janitor and then you go to work at a sperm bank, that's probably like not the worst thing.
It's probably not the worst thing.
Yeah. I'd rather do that than be Dr. Phil's wife or a mustache.
Oh my God.
Okay. So this is a porta potty cleaner.
No.
This job is a combination of a garbage collector and a gastroenterologist, and it's more disgusting than both of them put together. Using a tank and a vacuum tube, they suck up all the waste in a portable toilet.
Stop.
Or a porta potty.
Stop. Is that how they clean those things?
They also wash down the surfaces that could possibly be soiled inside, because we've all seen that.
Stop.
Have you, I mean, everyone who's listening has obviously seen a porta potty, and you lift it up, and it's just
or
like a wasteland on the bottom of just like pool of shit and like waste.
It's disgusting.
That's your job. Okay, that's bad.
That's really bad.
That's bad.
Well, so where do they hook up the hose though? Like if
there's
so,
not, remember when we were walking the dogs the other day and there was that big plumbing tank with the engine running and it had a giant tank. They were pumping sewage into a huge tank. That's probably what they do.
No, I don't remember that.
They probably bring a giant plastic
well,
tank with tubes
saying.
On it.
So
and
if,
an engine.
If yeah, no, I get it. But if you go up to like the back of the porta potty, like the side, and you hook up a hose and then you pump it out, that's really not the worst thing.
Hooking it up and getting it in there and making sure it's all clean
no.
is probably gnarly.
No, after you pump everything out and then you go in there and clean it, that job sucks.
I think the whole thing sucks.
That sucks.
I think turning on an engine to hear hot poop being flung through a tube so you can carry it home, that sucks.
Yeah, it's not the greatest. That's pretty gross.
Yeah, that's gnarly.
I guess I never thought about how porta potties got cleaned. I figured that they just like threw them out somewhere. I didn't think that they like cleaned them out.
Why do you think they're so sanitary all the time?
Well, why don't they just like line it with something that they could just remove without needing a tank and a vacuum and all that?
I just think,
is it too risky?
No, I think it's one of those things where the system that is currently implemented is easy and works so that they won't look into changing the standard. Similar to how like a lot of, I know this is very different, but how a lot of cars, their GPS built in is very old and seemingly clunky, right. Even on the new cars. It's because they work and they know they work. So they'd rather go with something safe than having to change the whole status quo. Yeah, that's fucked.
It's pretty gross.
Anything dealing with someone else's poop? Aside from my own tribes?
You've never dealt with my poop.
Yeah, but if we had a kid, I would deal with their poop.
Yeah. So none of us in this house matter, but everyone else's poop.
What? I have.
It's always like the toilet upstairs in our bedroom like sometimes breaks, and I've seen your poop. Julia, don't go in there. I pooped. I need you to help me fix the toilet. Don't look at my poop.
It's cute. It's like a little...
Stop! Stop. That's always the worst, though. Like, you poop, and then you realize that the toilet's broken after the fact.
And you're not a handy MacGyver who knows how to fix toilets on the fly like me. Moving on, we have mosquito researcher. So, maybe at first this doesn't sound bad, but scientists fighting malaria must study the biting habits of the mosquito that spreads it.
Nasty.
In Brazil, the scientists offer themselves as bait. One researcher caught 500 mosquitoes in 3 hours, which means he endured 3,000 bites, or an average of 17 per minute for 180 minutes in a row. The downside is they occasionally contract malaria.
Yeah, but like you can get rid of those with malaria, like tablets and things. You can take medicine for malaria.
I think that's, you know what? I think Rome should do that. She loves that stuff.
What, malaria tablets?
No, she loves like mosquitoes.
Rome hates bugs.
She hates bugs.
That's not even the worst thing in the world to me. I feel like if I was like, all right, this is what I got to do to make ends meet. Yeah, fuck it. I'll let the mosquitoes bite me.
Okay, no, no. There's like a whole list of things to do to make ends meet before you want to just go get bit by mosquitoes all day.
Yeah, but I don't think that's the grossest job I've ever heard.
It's not the grossest. It's gnarly, but it's not the grossest.
It's pretty gnarly.
I think that's more of like, that would probably exhaust me.
That's it, just outrageously impressive.
Yeah, yeah. It's...
Well, because I imagine they have to let the mosquitoes bite them without like swatting them away or like killing them. Or like they have to just sit there and feel the burn of 500 mosquito bites at a time.
Yeah.
Like how fucking itchy is that guy or girl? Does he get like some time off in between research to go fucking heal?
I wonder if they take something for the itching.
I don't know. Maybe it'll interfere with their study if they do.
Maybe. It's just crazy to think that like that's the most efficient way to find out about mosquitoes is just to get bit.
I'd get a fake person.
Yeah, right?
Make it smell like person. Spray the fuck out of it with some Axe body spray.
We just need
like one of those dummies that you do CPR on and just chuck them out in the yard and
you
be like,
their face
all right,
on
here
your
go.
Face and you're like, we need a Westworld in real life for that kind of stuff. You test them there.
Yeah.
Right? Westworld would be so useful.
Yes. I say, let's funnel all that money into building Westworld. A Westworld just so we can study mosquitoes.
Yeah. Study mosquitoes. Not go to Westworld and have fun and, you know, fuck around. All right. Embalmer.
Nope. I'm already out of this one.
This is specifically for Jenna.
I'm already out.
Embalming is the art of science that deals with preserving human remains from decomposing.
No. Not for me.
I can already smell it.
Really not for me.
The embalmer is the person who cleans the corpse.
Nope.
Drains the body fluids.
Nope.
And takes the internal organs and stuffs the cadaver with fillers and air to make it look as nothing was taken out.
Nope. Mm-mm. Nope. Not for me.
So.
I feel like if you did that job...
There's a type of person that is okay with dead bodies. There just is. Otherwise, no one would do those jobs.
No, I feel like you can get desensitized to that to the point where I think people
are way more prone to being desensitized to it than others. I honestly feel I believe that.
If you grew up like in a funeral home or like that's your family business or something like that, you can be very comfortable doing these things because you've heard people talk that work at funeral homes that are like, you know, it runs in our family and we see it as like a service.
You no longer view it as a dead body. You view it as like a client and you're doing stuff and
right. You're helping the family and yeah.
I still believe that like there are certain people that could never, ever, ever do those jobs no matter what.
Yeah, probably.
But that goes for everything.
Mm-hmm.
That's just nasty.
It's just really not for me.
Just draining it into a bucket.
Yeah, no, it's not for me. Don't breathe in like that when you're talking about draining someone's body of fluid. Don't do it. You nasty. You nasty.
Okay, the next one is, oh, do I not need Jesus? Just I'm nasty?
You nasty and you need Jesus.
I have Jesus, pocket Jesus. Roadkill collector. Is this Shan?
Yeah, right? It is Shan. Our friend Shan. Dude from Vine, the one that goes out, Chris Melberger.
She picks up dead animals.
She loves dead animals. See, but this is another one. No matter what you say, Shan has forever changed my view of dead animals because she literally is like, I think they're just as beautiful when they're dead as they are when they're alive. So
why should we stop appreciating animals once they die?
Yeah, it's really fucking profound and beautiful.
Yeah, it's interesting. So I mean, I still could never
If you had someone like Shan running around collecting roadkill that was like, I saved it and I got it.
Yeah.
She would probably love that job. She would feel sad, but she would like find a lot of little things that she would love to keep. Like she likes their teeth and their hair and their tails and their hooves. If they let her keep some things, I think she would like that.
Okay. I personally think that this next one, I want to hear the description of it. It's just roadkill collector.
So they just go around like highways and stuff?
Yeah, they go to the sides of roads and make sure they're in the middle of roads as well when it's causing traffic and shit. This next one sounds nice. No, I'm just kidding. That's fucked up. It's called an animal masturbator. EBB, send me your dog.
Oh my God.
As many scientists and researchers need animal sperm, there must be someone to provide it. It doesn't just happen. So, obtaining sperm from large animals such as pigs or bulls can be also a little bit dangerous because you're getting kind of personal with them. They'll fuck you up. They don't like it.
Mm-hmm.
So, just jerking bulls off.
Mm. Mm-hmm. It's pretty gross. It's pretty fucked. But I feel like, you know when the like zookeepers and zoo animals, whatever, when they have pandas or like some other type of endangered species that they're trying to like have procreate so they can keep the species going.
Yeah.
I feel like I've heard of that with like pandas and shit where they like have to really help them and or like try to do it artificially a little bit in order to keep the species going.
Yeah, no, for sure. I mean,
I feel like I would rather do it to a panda than like a bull that's gonna maybe break your neck.
Well, you wouldn't do it like out in the wild, like, come here.
No, like wherever your space is. But like, think of you're doing it to a panda. He probably just sits there and chills and like stares around. Yeah. Or like a sloth.
Mm-hmm.
Sloth wouldn't even really move.
You might kill it.
God.
They'd just be like, armpit sniffer.
Okay, that is fucking foul. Do not. No! Oh my God! No! Don't smell my armpits! Stop!
Working for cosmetics companies, armpit sniffers are paid for smelling other people's armpits to determine the effects of companies' products such as deodorants and sprays.
Wait, but doesn't... Stop it. Doesn't so much of that depend on the person that's using
probably.
The
product? But they probably have the person likely shower on site, dry off, and put on only that product.
Yeah, but so much of body odor has to do with, like, your diet.
Well, yeah, they're not doing it to one person. They probably have a whole group of, you know, subjects. Don't get personally offended that they just smell armpits to
test. I'm offended.
Yeah, they probably have, like, a protein guy who eats nothing but chicken and protein.
That's what I'm saying.
Smells different than the vegan or the you know, taco eater all the time.
Yeah, if your diet is heavy in certain types of spices, like you would have a different smell, like walking around than someone else. You know what I mean? Or if you eat meat or not eat meat.
That's why the cosmetics companies aim to please all odors.
How can we know that they're really doing their job here and having it go on all tips to different types of people's bodies? How do you know it's not just Bill that does it every time?
Probably is Bill.
It's Bill that puts it on, and it's Karen that's smelling them. All of them. And they're all so done with their jobs that they just say everything smells great. Keep it moving.
Karen, go away. I'm sick of Karen smelling me. Imagine that. By the end of the day, you're just like, Karen, stop smelling me, Karen.
Yeah, and you're also like, I can't fucking smell anything anymore. It just smells like deodorant. Don't stop trying to smell me, boy.
Okay. Don't all right. Do it. Next one. It's okay. We only have a couple more. And then we can just go back to Jersey Shore
and smell each other.
Crime scene cleaner.
No.
A job for only the most hardened. A crime scene cleaner is responsible for making things nice again after homicides, suicides, accidents, etc. As you might assume, performing this job includes removing blood, stains, body parts, bodily fluids, and other gory things.
I've just got physically sick and can't feel my arms anymore. So,
why is your thing when you get like sick and like nervous or freaked out or anxious, your arms go?
Because I get so scared that the blood is like draining out of my extremities. It happens in my legs too, like my hamstrings. And like, I'm not kidding. If I get scared enough, I lose feeling in my upper arms.
Okay, sorry.
Like first, you know.
Can you feel this?
Stop it! Stop. Like, my hands will go real cold and, like, that kind of thing.
You just really got, like, loss of feeling from me saying that?
Right here. I get a weird feeling right here and then in my hamstrings. Stop it. Stop. And I'm going to get scared enough. It, like, goes. Like, the time we were on the plane.
On the plane to Arizona.
No, that one. But the one that was worse than that was when I was going to Gatlinburg with Mamrie and we were flying through, like, a lightning storm. And I was sitting by myself.
Yeah.
And it was the most terrifying flight. I couldn't feel my arms.
Mm-hmm.
That's what that story just did to me.
I don't know if I've ever felt a sensation like that. I know I've gotten so scared or so much anxiety at once that, like, I have physiological sensations. I just don't remember, like, my arms losing their sensation or feelings. All right. Last one.
Could you ever do that, though? Could you ever clean up a crime scene?
No, I don't think so.
I watch a lot of Dateline.
I think, honestly...
I can't do that.
I don't... Like, I've actually thought... Like, when I was in college, I was very lightly, very casually, like early stages of thinking of what it would be like if I was a paramedic. Because I kind of wanted to do it. Very surface level. I didn't actually pursue it. I wasn't seriously considering it. I was just thinking about it, you know, at one point. And I was like, oh, it'd be cool to help people be a paramedic, go out at night. And then I realized the kind of shit that you go through every night as a paramedic. And it scared me right off.
Thinking about it, like, traumatizing it. Like,
and then you
I
know,
have friends
recently,
that do that. And they were like,
then,
no.
No, but, like, I mean, and then, you know, it's the same thing as any job. Like, you learn it's just your job. You don't have to take these things, like, personally. They're not real people. But what, I mean, they're not your people. They are people. But once they're dead, you have to treat them like they're dead or whatever. Anyway, when we were in a car accident recently, and we were in the paramedics truck, we were experiencing crazy trauma. And those guys were so unfazed to our insane trauma that it was like, whoa, you guys must have seen some shit every day.
Well, yeah. Well, you know, my friend does that and has done that for years. And he would just tell us, like, you know, come home and tell us little tips about how to live your life. Because they see so many horrible things, you know?
Yeah.
Like, even just the always wearing your seatbelt or, like, please lock your door at night. Fucking just shut shit where you're like, why are you saying that? They're like, just don't ask. Like, just trust me. Just fucking do it, please. Yeah. You're like, I actually don't want to know.
Yeah.
So, thank you.
Well, those jobs really fucking suck. But you know what doesn't suck is driving for Lyft. And right now, if you sign up as a driver for Lyft at lyft.com/JennaJulien, you will get a $500 driver bonus.
Oh my God.
Towards your credit. Driving for Lyft is awesome, guys. I don't know if you're an actor or actress right now between jobs, or you're actually just looking for work, or maybe you have some free time on the weekends or at night. You can drive for Lyft on the hours that work for you. It's super convenient. And it especially helps if you love people, because if you like having conversations, which I think is really fun as work, you can just drive people around and have conversations, it'll work for you. Right now, you can sign up for Lyft as a driver, and you can get paid up to $35 an hour, and you get started very fast and very easily. You can drive mornings, nights, weekends, whatever works for you. You just flip into driver mode when you are available and you start making money. Plus, only Lyft drivers earn tips from within the app, which will add up fast, especially if you're a good person. And you get tipped. You can also get paid right away when you don't have to get, you don't have to wait weeks or however many days it normally takes to get paid for other jobs. You can cash out instantly with Express Pay on Lyft. There are plenty of other ride sharing apps out there, but everyone likes driving for Lyft best because they treat their drivers right. Lots of people started as customers and now drive for Lyft. So right now, if you go to lyft.com/JennaJulien, that's lyft.com/JennaJulien, you can get a $500 driver bonus when you sign up using our show. That's lyft.com/JennaJulien. Check it out, guys. Thank you so much, Lyft.
Thank you, Lyft.
And our other wonderful sponsor this week is MeUndies.
Ride or die, MeUndies.
Sexiest underwear on the market. The coolest looking underwear on the market. And especially this time of year, the best underwear to buy for that special someone who maybe rejected you the first time. But when you get them some MeUndies, they will reconsider. I promise. Nothing's wrong with me. Just sharing some tricks. This Valentine's Day, guys, give the greatest gift, which is MeUndies. They have, obviously Valentine's Day is really, it's stressful because you don't know what to get. You don't know how to surprise. I mean, it's just all sorts of like decisions and shit that you don't want to think. Go to MeUndies right now and they will make everything easy. Okay. Flowers are so last year.
2009.
Last week, even.
2016.
Don't panic, guys. Go to MeUndies right now and you get your underwear by February 14th for your loved ones or yourself. MeUndies are the perfect gift for you and your Valentine's this holiday. They're unbelievably soft and come in limited edition Valentine's prints, which they're going to be dope. So make sure you check those out. They know that the special someone in your life deserves a special fabric, which is why their underwear is made exclusively out of modal, a fabric with a touch, not once, not twice, but three times softer than cotton. Right now, guys, go to MeUndies.com/JennaJulien and you will get 20% off your first order and check out their Valentine's collection because you will not be disappointed. Thank you, MeUndies.
Thank you, MeUndies. Thank you, Lyft. Thank you, sponsors. All right, Julian.
All right, we've reached the second half of the podcast. Now this is where it becomes
a very... I'm the sweetest bitch you'll ever meet.
This becomes a scholarly podcast, so prepare for the intelligence factor.
Going to Jersey Shore, bitch!
We are going to do Jersey Shore character quizzes. Which Jersey Shore character are you?
Yes, yes, yes. We're going back in time.
So we have three quizzes. I say you take one. I'll take another.
We can take them at the same time.
Oh, okay.
Take yours on your phone. I'll take mine on my phone.
Smart. I texted you that, right?
Go Vinny. Yeah.
You know, and you know, but you guys might not know. In college, I dressed up as Vinny one year. The whole entire year. No, I'm just kidding. For Halloween.
I've Vinny cosplayed for an entire year. No, the show is so good.
So good.
It's so good. It's so fun to rewatch it.
It's great to rewatch. If you can creep deep enough on my Twitter, which some of you fucking already have, you'll see me dressed up as Vinny. It's a good costume.
I look like Vinny. Oh, you're so cute. Why Vinny, though?
I just identified with him because he was a little bit weird and offbeat, not as like cool as the other guys.
He's a nice guy.
No, I don't know. I just like Vinny. All right, here we go. 15 questions for this one.
I'm not ready, fam. This podcast is not sponsored by Jersey Shore.
No, we already read you the sponsors.
All right. The quiz is called, which Jersey Shore star are you?
Yep. 15 questions.
So play along.
Play along if you guys would like.
I'm not going to be able to give you your answer if you play along.
We'll link them. Yeah. So go into the description right now. We'll link them in a row. The first one will be on top, second one, third one, and you can play with us. This is the one on buddytv.com. Which Jersey Shore star are you? Okay.
Hell yeah.
Here we go.
I'm here for this.
Read the first question.
Oh, I just got a giant ad that just popped up.
Yes.
How would you describe your sense of style? Tight fitting, skin bearing, flashy, designer, anything black or reserved and casual?
Anything black. I wear all black all the time.
Oh, I mean, I used to be very tight fitting, skin bearing, but I'm going to say reserved and casual at this point.
Yeah.
Thanks, Julian.
In a group situation, you're most likely to A, take charge, B, sit back and stay quiet, C, try to be the center of attention, or C, D, find someone to hit on.
Sit back and stay quiet.
Yeah, me too.
I'm not going to do any of those other things.
Okay.
Which word best describes you? Hot, badass, fun, crazy. I'm saying fun.
I'm saying fun.
I'm fun.
What's your motto? All you need is love. Don't hate the player, hate the game. Girls just want to have fun, or go with the flow. Girls just want to have fun.
Go with the flow.
I'm girls just want to
have fun. Girls just want to have fun.
Who are you in a fight? The one throwing the punch. Oh, the one throwing the punch, the one getting punched for mouthing off. The one breaking it up, or the one staying out of it?
The one breaking it up.
I honestly feel like I am too. Yeah. I've broken up fights.
Me too. I don't throw a punch until someone's physically attacking me.
What is your dream?
To have the world's sexiest body, to find the love of your life and settle down, to be a celebrity, or to make lots of money. Find the love of your life and settle down. Ew.
Me too.
Ow, gross. Make sure you smash that unsubscribe button. Don't.
No, you are only allowed to say that on your channel. This is a shared channel. I want you to stop.
Okay, what's your greatest fear? Rejection, commitment, boredom, or betrayal?
Betrayal.
Where's Airplane?
Betrayal.
Yeah, I'm not really scared of boredom, rejection, or commitment, so I guess betrayal.
What do you look for in a romantic partner? Sense of humor, sexy body, sweet personality, a pulse.
Sense of humor.
God, why are we picking the same stuff? Can you not, like, announce it?
Ew.
Right. Ew. What is the biggest misconception about you? That you're nuts, that you're boring, that you're dumb, that you're a jerk.
That I'm nuts.
That you're nuts?
Mm-hmm.
Mine is that I'm a jerk. I think people look at my face and they're like, that
you're
guy's a jerk.
Jerk.
I already selected it. Hello.
Which book would you most likely...
To read.
To read. How to Pick Up Women. 100 Best Techno Songs of All Time. That's a book? A book.
Anger Management.
Anger Management. What's a book? I guess...
Anger management techniques.
Yeah, because I'm not going to read a book about 100 techno songs.
No, it's a good thing to know, too. What's the hardest part about living with you? You won't shut up. You're messy. You bring lots of people over, and you have major mood swings.
Major mood swings.
I'm not messy. I'm really not.
You're just a tornado, but you're not messy.
I'm not messy. I live clean. Like, I clean shit up. I won't shut up.
What's your favorite activity? Dancing in a club? Kicking it in the hot tub, cuddling, or partying?
Cuddling.
Kicking it in the hot tub.
Ooh, I'm going to be Sammy because I picked cuddling.
Oh, no.
How's your love
life?
You could
be Snooki. You're happily attached to someone. You're single and loving it. You're single and looking. Happily attached to someone.
Happily attached. Your ideal nickname would tell others that you're hot and you know it. Make you sound fun and crazy. Show that you are a sweet and cute. Okay, this is basically, come on. All right.
Mine would be short, simple, and normal. Tight.
Mine would be telling others that you're hot and you know it.
Have you ever cheated on a significant other? Yes, you can't help myself. You can't help myself? Yes, but you learn your lesson. No, you never have, never will. No, because you'll never have a significant other.
Who are you?
No.
Who are you?
Oh, okay. I'm Sammy.
I'm Ronnie.
Oh my God! Stop! Ren, stop! My thing's like going in and out. Ren, you traumatized me, Ren! Stop it!
I can't believe we just got Ron and Sam. I swear to guys, this is legit.
No!
This is legit.
Shut the fuck up. Are you kidding me? Ren, stop!
Ren!
Ren, stop! You traumatized me, Ryan.
RIP me, because I'm a headphone user.
I cannot believe that.
I can't believe we got Ron. I can't believe you somehow got Sammy and I got Ronnie. Like, there was no female or male question on there.
Neither of us are anything like those two people.
I think that's pretty accurate.
Well, like, I don't... I'm just so at a loss right now.
I'm Ron, you're Sam. Deal with it.
Ryan, stop. Ryan. All right. Are we taking the BuzzFeed one now?
Drop top.
Is this the same? Is this just which character, which cast? Again, we're doing this? I swear.
We don't have to do all of them.
Fuck if we get Ron and Sam again.
Oh, we should. Okay, let's do this.
These are pictures. All right, so this will be the second one in the description.
Okay.
It's the one from BuzzFeed.
Pick a Seaside Heights landmark.
We have a picture of the Shore Store, a picture of Karma, a picture of the house, and a picture of Rivoli's.
Rivoli's. I'm Rivoli's.
Aw, I'm the house.
Pick a protein. Meatballs, salami, prosciutto, sausage.
Oh my God.
Salami.
I can't pick any of those.
Okay, what you used to eat most? I would say salami.
Meatballs.
Okay. Pick an errand. Gym, tan, laundry.
fucking all of it. Ooh.
Ooh, I like fucking all of it.
Fucking all of it.
Yeah.
Pick a suitcase. There's a pink one, an Italian flag one, a garbage bag, and a leopard one.
I'm the Italian flag one.
I would be the
because it's the
bag.
Most functional suitcase out of all of them.
Pick the most iconic moment item in the house. There's the dinner table, the hot tub, the duck phone, and the smush room bed.
Duck phone.
Duck phone.
Big time. Choose an acronym. Gym, Tam, Laundry, GTL, DTF, down to fuck, MVP, Mike, Vinny, Pauly, GFA, Grenade, Free America.
GTL.
Same. Pick a drink. The Ron juice.
Which is gross, by the way. I've made it.
Which is like watermelon and...
Watermelon, cherries, vodka, cranberry juice,
way
ice,
too many
blended.
Red fruits, way too many.
Ron juice, red wine, tequila shots, or vodka shots?
Vodka shots.
I'm going red wine. Please.
Who are you?
Yeah!
Me too!
We're both Pauly D.
We both made Pauly D.
Okay, you know, how can we be Ron and Sam and Pauly D? Yikes, yikes.
Also, if you rewatch that show, you'll quickly realize that Pauly is like easily the coolest dude.
Well, because
on the show. He's
was,
just so happy
like,
and funny, and
they were all mostly like 21 to 23,
and
24.
He was older.
He was 29 when the show started. Yeah. Like, yeah. Of course, he's gonna be like he's gonna sit around and laugh while everyone's just being an idiot.
Yeah, and also like he knew when to like. Make jokes and have fun, and he also knew when to like clear out and like be an adult.
All right,
here we go. Last one. Which Jersey Shore character are you? When you go to the gym, do you focus on the abs? It's all about the ripped abs. The guys, it's about getting their attention. Gym, I don't go to the gym. My arms, bigger the better, or the sauna?
My arms, the bigger the better.
That's a lie. I'm the sauna. I don't even work out.
I guess abs.
I just go sit in the sauna.
Abs.
How tan would you say you are? Very pretty, kinda, not that tan.
Kinda. I'm kinda tan. I just got a spray
I'm
tan.
Not that tan.
You're kinda tan.
I'm kinda tan?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Which of these best describes how you might style your hair? My hair is pretty easy. I wouldn't do much. Gel, baby, gel. I dye it. Oh, okay. Well, that one's me. You got to go for the poof. I'd go with a faux hawk. I'd get extensions.
Dye it.
Both dye it. Why are there so many choices on each question?
Which Jersey Shore cast member would you most want to hook up with? Oh, my God. Sammy, Snooki, JWoww, Angelina, Ronnie's situation, Pauly D.
Angelina. Oh, God.
Okay, you don't tell me. I won't tell you.
All right,
just
I won't
tell
go.
You. Oh, I mean,
What's your favorite thing to do? You got to pick. What's your favorite thing to do on the beach? Work out, make out, tan, play in the water. Play in the water. Why
play
else are you
water.
At the beach? What kind of music do you listen to?
House hip hop. Italian music?
I listen to pop.
Hip hop.
Half the fun of a summer is in the shore is hooking up. Who do you want to hook up with? I'm a guy looking for a hot girl, a guy who will hook up with anyone, a girl looking for a tough guy, a girl who looking for love.
I'm a girl looking for love.
I'm a guy who's looking for a hot girl. Continue.
Oh my God, there's more questions?
No. Oh God.
Jeez,
this is
like
brutal.
A test.
All right, let's just speed through it.
If you give yourself a nickname, which of these would you choose? Muggsy, the Paris Hilton of Paris. G-Money, Sex, CD with two X's. The Destination, Kooky, just a short version of my name is fun.
Kooky.
Kooky is a good one.
What are you?
Just a short version of my name is fun.
All right, besides Jersey Shore, what's your favorite MTV show? Next, The Hills, The Real World, 16 and Pregnant.
Real
wow, this
world.
Is old.
Real
I'm
world.
Next.
Real world.
Next.
Next was a great show.
You go shopping at Boss's t-shirt store, you'd buy a shirt that had which of these on it? The Italian flag, princess, guns for hire, porn star in training.
The Italian flag.
Princess.
I don't want porn star in training on my shirt, fam.
Do you have piercings? Yes. No. Yes, I'm pierced. I have my ears pierced. No.
I have my ears pierced.
Hot tubs are a great way to get to know hot strangers a bit better, relax, get cozy with your special someone, or get an infection.
Ew. It says ew in the question.
Relax.
Get cozy with someone.
Back off. I'm trying to relax.
Do you find the term Guido offensive? No, not really. No, not at all. Yeah, I'm proud to be Guido. Actually, I prefer to be called Guidette. Yeah, actually.
Yeah, actually. I am very offended. Which cast member could you see yourself being best friends with? Pauly D. Easy. Please be over. Oh my God, there's more questions.
No, there isn't. Oh my God.
Okay, right. I think this is it though.
You and your friends are going out to a Let's Jersey Shore
it.
Bar.
Let's just finish it.
Which of these outfits do you wear? Jeans and a white t-shirt and a Jesus piece. Baggy jeans, a wife beater and a gold chain. Short jean shorts and a tight tank top. Tight ripped jeans and a belly bearing top. A mini skirt and a tight top.
I'm kind of feeling the mini skirt.
I'm wearing ripped jeans. I don't.
All right, I'm going to wear tight ripped jeans and a belly bearing top.
Hell yeah. If you went to the Jersey Shore, would you be loyal to your boyfriend or girlfriend? No way. Or yeah, I would.
Yeah, I would.
Yeah, I would.
Which of these jobs would you be willing to do to make some money? Exotic dancer, male or female. Work in a t-shirt store, DJ, bartend. I don't like to work.
Bartend.
Hey. What do you have hanging around your neck? A whole lot of hotties, definitely.
That's a real answer. A necklace my sweetie gave me. A gold cross, of course. Nothing. Or a whole lot of hotties. A necklace my sweetie gave me. Look at three of them.
I don't have a necklace my sweetie gave me.
12 of them. Where would you want to get a tattoo? My arms, my lower back, my back shoulders, my ankle. I wouldn't get a tattoo. My arms.
Arms.
Now it's asking for our birthday.
Mine's April 17th, 1921. Would you go back to school to get smarter? Nah, I'm plenty smart already. All right, I'm continuing.
Okay, I'm still typing in my birthday.
Generating your results. Wow, this is the oldest, most outdated quiz ever. Wait, is this working?
I swear to God, if we just did all of that. It just took me to another page.
Oh, wait, just wait a sec. Just no, just stay on that page. Just doing, it's like.
Oh, mine's going now, too.
Oh, my God, is this not going to fucking work?
I'm the sweetest bitch you'll ever meet.
Skip to results. Do you see that?
Ew.
On the right? It's going to load and then.
Oh my God, ew. Ron, stop. Ron.
Raindrop. Drop top.
Ron.
Ron, stop. Have you seen that meme? All right, this is not working. If this doesn't work, I'm going to be pissed.
Ron, stop.
Why am I holding my cell phone up like it's 1995?
I don't know. But this was fun. Anyways,
this was fun.
Skip the results.
The quizzes are linked. I'm turning off Wi-Fi. The quizzes are linked in the description. If you guys want to take them with us, or you probably already did if you were doing that. Oh, here we go.
Oh, shit. Fuck. I'm Sammy again.
Oh, my God.
What?
I'm Angelina. No. That's not okay. Why am I Angelina?
I'm the Kim Kardashian of Staten Island.
Why am I Angelina? That's not okay.
Because you trash. Boy, you trash.
I guess the only thing I would have in common with her is that I did 2 seasons and then...
I don't get it.
I would not be able to last 6 seasons on that show.
I don't get it.
I wouldn't be able to last in that environment.
Is it because you packed all your stuff in trash bags?
I didn't pick the trash bag for that. Is it funny? Is it funny?
Yeah. I'm the sweetest bitch you'll ever meet again.
Are you Sammy again?
Yeah.
Ooh, I'm seeing a pattern here.
No, it's because all the answers that are like, go out and party and fuck dudes is like not. No.
That's true. So. Anyway, great podcast.
Anyways.
This was a good one.
This is fun.
I hope you guys enjoyed the podcast. Make sure you stop by and check out the sponsors below. We will see you guys next week for another one. And in the meantime, don't watch Dr. Phil. Watch Jersey Shore. Goodbye, everybody.
Bye.